Well, you know, I think everybody knows that that was a big one going in. Obviously, we talked about just being the next conference game. We're going to try and treat every one of those games like a playoff game, and this was certainly no different. But knew probably top to bottom the best opponent we've played, you know, to this point. You know, without taking, don't want to take anything obviously away from Murray State. So, you know, arguably say that, but if not the best, one of the best up to this point. Going on the road, their homecoming. You know, there was just a lot of challenges coming off of a tough loss, our first loss of the season, the way we lost it, you know, in such a tough fashion. We really wanted to see how our guys would respond. You know, and I think to see them pull together, kind of get back-to-back and you know, not have a lot of folks up there with us, you know, it's just a long trip. And to really see those guys come together in the manner they did was really great. Offensively, you know, we knew they did some things defensively that was going to make it hard to run the ball, especially early. And we knew we had some things in the passing game we wanted to try and exploit. We started that early on in the game, had a big play early on, and really most of the night really threw the ball well, had great pass protection, caught the ball well. You know, and so that went on. And then, of course, as the game went on, our running game really started to open up, and I think we ended up with a really balanced night offensively. I think we met every goal. I think we had one penalty, a little movement. I mean, but, you know, to hit almost every single goal in a game against a really quality defense was just outstanding offensively. Defensively, we thought we got back to who we are, stopping the run, good pressure on the quarterback, and, of course, they had a guy that was very mobile. We worked on that all week, and, you know, he still made some plays on us, but I thought we had good pressure, stopped the running game well. And they had some yards, which, you know, is kind of just the nature of the game today. But, you know, we made the stops when we needed to. Had a really good game defense. I thought we tackled well. And then special teams, once again, back to, you know, where we want to be. I think, you know, we had one mess up in the special teams, you know, on one punt. Just didn't really go where we wanted it to go. But other than that, really good night special teams. Just a great team win. As we said, over a quality opponent. So really proud of our guys and for our guys and staff.
You excited about the opportunity to play the number one defense in the country?
You know, I think we better be. You know, I mean, it's another challenge, you know, and that's the things I told our, you know, we've said since the day we've been here about our league and quality, and this is just another one. And what you got here, not only is a group of really good-looking guys, you know, if you just turn on the film and say, man, these guys look like they should look. I mean, just, you know, every secondary player, I believe, is over 6 foot tall. They've got big D linemen who can run. You've got linebackers big and fast, but they're well-coached. They're solid. They're very sound, don't do a lot of things. They're going to make you beat them. You know, and I think that's another mark of a good team. You know, they're going to do what they do and make you make plays. So I think anytime you've got a quality defense, of course, they've got the number one group in the country right now, that gives you more confidence offensively. You know, and that's kind of how we want to start. We want to always play great defense here. And that's going to come with time. But, you know, that's just – right now, to know you're playing the number one group in the country, that's daunting, but it sort of should be a challenge we should embrace and be excited about, too.
They are good defensively, front to back, side to side. Is there one area that they are particularly strong in?
That's a good question. I don't know that. I know, you know, one thing stands out to me is how athletic they are in the secondary, and everybody says, well, you're always athletic, but to have big guys that can run allows you to do more things. You know, I think you know, when you got those guys, you kind of got erasers out there all the time, you know, and when a ball breaks, they've got a guy they think can run it down. They want to put a lot of people in the box. They can single you up, they think. You know, I think when you look across the board, though, when you see big athletic guys up front and then linebackers, you know, all are big with size but also can run. I mean, you're kind of looking for those weaknesses and you just don't see a lot. Not a heavy blitz team, you know, and I think, once again, that's those things that if somebody is a heavy blitz team, that's kind of that feast or famine type deal, and we're kind of getting to the point where we're embracing that a little bit. You know, if somebody really, we feel like we're picking it up, and that opens up some other things. That's kind of what I'm alluding to. They're going to kind of get in there and play. They'll bring a guy here and there, like, you know, like we all do. But it's more, we're going to make you beat us, make you be sound. And I think that's one of the theories out there nowadays, because the number of reps and the number of plays and how good offenses are today, can you consistently do it down the field? And that's one of the things we want to pride ourselves on offensively, is that we can take a drive and not make a mistake. And so go back to our previous game, we didn't turn the ball over. And that's, if there's anything we talk about, and these guys get hammered on a daily basis, it's ball security. Whether it's him making the right read, whether him putting the ball away, whatever those things are that allow you to keep working down the field. And you know, defense is kind of where we are. We will make you make a play. And hopefully something's going to happen between there and the goal line. So they're not, no, they're not a huge blitz team, to answer that question.
Josh, can you talk about how your last couple of weeks have gone? Your, you know, last four games is getting more and more catches, more and more yards. Talk to the comfort level you're getting into now, and how the last, really the last four games, maybe the last three in particular, have gone for you.
I mean, I'm very comfortable. You know, there's things that I need to work on in my game, you know, to make me better, make the team better. But, I mean, it's just, you know, just building that trust up. You know, Max believes in me. He believes he puts the ball in the air, I can make a play on it. You know, the coach is trusting me, you know, to call a play to come my way. So, I mean, whenever, you know, I have the opportunity, I just got to make the best of it.
The, well, 8 for 124, 5 for 150, you know, Georgia State in last week. 100-yard games today. Getting to be a routine for you?
I mean, you know, during the game, I don't even, you know, I don't think about stats. I don't know. I hear about it after the game from either the coaches or my family. But, you know, during the game, it's, you know, I'm all about, you know, getting the win, whether I'm catching the ball or not. Just like at Jacksonville, when we ran the ball, I mean, my role in that game was the block. We was running the ball well. I mean, we broke a school record. And then last game, you know, the passing game and the running game was there. So, I mean, it's basically a team effort. You know, so, I mean, when my number's called, I just make plays.
The play, and I think this was you, the play in the end zone, was it early in the game? We go way up high. Did you have that and the ground knocked it away? I mean, we're sitting way back here, so it's hard for us to see what's going on, and there was no replay. But it,
yeah, I caught the ball, but, I mean, I have to come up with the ball. Uh-huh. So, I mean, when I caught up there, I tried to make, you know, an extra, you know, move to the end zone, and when I hit the ground, you know, it came out, but, you know, that's just something, that's another part of my game where I got to work on, where, you know, I just got to be smarter with it. But, I mean,
well,
that's your question.
Well,
yeah,
I mistake or something, I mean, you went up so high and it got it, and I didn't know if you had had it enough, and then just...
Oh, yeah, I had possession of it just when I hit the ground, you know, it came out.
Oh. So, I mean, well, you were so far up in the air, I mean, the ground kind of hard, you know?
No, you know what I'm saying? I mean, when I look at it, that's a play that I should have made, mm-hmm. So, I mean... That's just like I said, it's something I got to work on, you know. But I feel like, you know, everything's going to work itself out.
And then as a receiver, what Coach had said, and I hadn't gone to check that, but they got a bunch of tall guys in their secondary. What kind of challenge will that be for you guys as receivers? We'll get to that part a little bit later, Max. you guys going against them, whether whatever coverage that they have, playing against taller DBs that they have?
My mindset is just to go make plays. I mean, to be honest, I don't, you know, I respect these opponents that we go up against, but I feel like, you know, I just got to go out there and play my best and give them the best effort I can give. And, I mean, just make plays, basically, you know. Just Max, you know, having him come from a school and have an experience, I mean, it makes it more comfortable for me to run my routes, knowing that, you know, he's going to get the ball to me. I just got to make plays. So whoever's guarding me, it's just my mindset just to make plays.
And then you want to just make a comment about playing against the number one defense in the country. Statistically, they are, and giving up against the pass, they're pretty good, too.
It's going to be exciting. I believe that our offense, you know, we're going to be excited all week. You know, just come out of practice. We got to work hard every day. And just have that mindset of just being unstoppable. No matter who's in front of us, just – you know, just play our game and do what we got to do, and I feel like, you know, we'll have success.
Have you ever played against the number one of anything?
Not high school basketball, that's it. Uh-huh. But against them one team, besides that. You know, I say it's going to be interesting.